Hi guys, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs, and I welcome you all in this part 2 of October Spotlight revision session. So as I have told you in the previous video, that in this video I will be covering the rest of the sections of Spotlight like international, banking, appointments, etc., etc. But in case you have missed the first video in which I have discussed the very important national current affairs of October month, then you can watch that video and the link will be provided in the description box. So why wait, let's begin the session quickly. But before that, those who have not subscribed this channel can subscribe it and hit this bell notification to get latest updates. Also, you can join this Telegram group where we share free quizzes, as well as you can connect with your mentors. So let's begin this international news section, which is going to be very interesting for you guys. Okay, so this is the first question. Which of the following company has announced to launch the world's first mining robot named Asteroid Mining Robot into the space by November 2020? So this is the world's first mining robot. So very important. So which company? So the right answer is Origin Space. This company belongs to China and it has announced to launch it by November 2020. अब तक तो हुआ नहीं, देखते हैं आगे होता है तो स्पॉटलाइट में आपको मिल जाएगा. मॉर्निंग टेल्स में डेली कवरेज होगी, सो वॉच मॉर्निंग टेल्स रेगुलरली. वॉट इज द वेन्यू ऑफ वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमिक फोरम्स 51st एनुअल मीटिंग डिस्कस्ड इन एमटी? सो आई होप दैट यू नो दैट व्हाट इज द आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन. सो इट इज ल्यूसर्न. नाउ गाइज, I had also told you about the regular or usual venue of this World Economic Forum's meeting. So that you will be telling me in the comment section below. What is India's overall rank in Oxfam's commitment to reducing inequality index? So this index, remember we had covered it, and it had three categories: public sector, public affairs, and there was one category on legal matters as well. So this index is covered in Morning Tales itself in detail, and here we will only discuss the answer of this question. So India's rank is 129. Which country is the most powerful in Asia Pacific region according to Asia Pacific Index for 2020? Since this index was not covered in Morning Tales, so let's discuss some details about it. It was launched by Lowy Institute, which is based in Sydney, and it mentions that India is the fourth most powerful country in Asia Pacific region. Now which country is at the first rank? It is US, then China, then Japan, then we have India. Australia is not mentioned, so Australia is not among the most powerful. Only we are discussing about the top four: US, China, Japan, and India. That's all for this question. Which of the following is not a parameter of Global Hunger Index 2020? Quite an important index it is, and it was discussed by Manish sir in detail. I had also discussed it. So your task is to tell me the organizations that released this index. Now, which of the following is not a parameter of this index? So the right answer is child stillbirth. This is not a parameter of this index. Which has become the first country in the world to implement the facial recognition for availing the government's online services? Remember, we had discussed this question. So what is the right answer, guys? It is Singapore. Singapore ne launch kiya hai ki agar aapke paas, agar aap facial recognition nahi dete, to you cannot avail the government online services. Online services ke liye facial recognition zaruri hai. Offline mein to facial recognition automatically hota hai. ठीक है. Which country has the cheapest plate of food in the world according to UN's cost of a plate of food report 2020? So which country is it? It is New York. Now this report was covered in PIB 247 in detail. Spotlight mein bhi hai aur PIB 247 mein detail mein covered hai. So New York has the cheapest. South Sudan has the costliest plate. India's is at the 28th rank. So that's all for this index. Where does NATO plan to establish its new space center? Remember, we had discussed about it as well as about NATO. So NATO se related facts, tell me in the comment section below. And for now, it's Germany where NATO plans to establish its new space center. What is the name of the drill exercise conducted by UNESCO's Intergovernmental Commission in the Indian Ocean region? So again, we had discussed it. What was the purpose? To create countries to make them tsunami resilient as well as the resilient against the disasters, ocean disasters. So what is the name of that exercise? It is IO Wave, which stands for Indian Ocean Wave 2020. Now, which Indian organization participated in this exercise? Come on, tell me in the comment section because I had discussed it at length in Morning Tales. So now it's kind of a test for you that how much do you remember? Which country has recently joined IMF? So the country has become the 190th member of IMF. Which is it? It is Andorra in Europe. Capital currency bhi bataya tha, ab aap bata do. मैंने बताया था कैपिटल करेंसी इन मॉर्निंग टेल्स. नाउ इट्स योर टर्न टू टेल मी द कैपिटल करेंसी ऑफ एंडोरा. व्हिच कंट्री होस्टेड द फर्स्ट एवर मिनिस्ट्रियल मीटिंग ऑफ G20 एंटी करप्शन वर्किंग ग्रुप? फेज वन के पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से इट वॉज डिस्कस्ड इन मॉर्निंग टेल्स एज वेल एज द डिटेल्स फ्रॉम द फेज टू पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू वर डिस्कस्ड इन PIB 247. दैट्स व्हाई आई कॉन्स्टेंटली से दिस थिंग रिपीटेडली. Watch Morning Tales, PIB and RBI 24 sessions regularly because they are current affairs. They are for your convenience. If you watch them on a daily basis, you will find it easy to remember the current affairs. And then when we provide you with the monthly revision sessions like this, it will add a bonus to your revision, a bonus to your preparation, as you will find it easier to revise the current affairs that you have seen or read in the month on a daily basis. That's why I constantly say this thing, watch PIB, RBI and Morning Tales regularly and do it on a regular basis. Read the PDFs on a regular basis. Okay. So which country hosted it for the first time? It is not for the first time. For the first time, ministerial meeting of G20 anti-working group, anti-corruption working group, first time Saudi Arabia, which is also the host of G20, president of G20 for 2020. Achha, ek cheez aur I remember, what is the theme of G20 for the year 2020? You know that every year G20 summit is held, and this year it was held at in the online mode. So what is the theme of G20 summit? Tell me in the comment section below. It has been provided एक्सटेंसिवली टू यू गाइज, डिस्कस भी बहुत बार कर चुके हैं. तो अब आप बताओ कि क्या थीम है G20 की 2020 में. विच टू कंट्रीज विल बी जॉइंड बाय फर्मन बेल्ट टनल? सो दिस इज द वर्ल्ड्स लॉन्गेस्ट इमर्स्ड टनल. रिमेंबर वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट इट. सो विच टू कंट्रीज विल बी जॉइंड बाय दिस टनल? इट इज डेनमार्क एंड जर्मनी इन बाल्टिक सी. रिमेंबर these facts, world's longest immersed as well as world's longest combined road and train tunnel. Remember, global FDI flows has fallen by -% in the first half of 2020 according to the Global Investment Trends Monitor report 2020. UN CTAD releases this report. Covered it in Morning Tales. I have covered it in detail in Morning Tales. If you remember, I have put out the chart in which various regions were there, the actual amount of FDI flows and the percentage by which they are going to fall in 2020 was also mentioned in that picture. So if you have seen that session, then it will this question will add to your advantage. So tell me the answer. It is 49%. Okay. Which state has performed the best in terms of improving the ease of doing business as per Doing Business in India report of UK India Business Council? Remember, I had asked you about the CEO of this council and we discussed this report in detail. So There were 106 UK based companies that were assessed in this report. So these 106 companies are presently operating in India, and out of these, 66% companies have verified this thing that it is nowadays getting easier to do business in India. So India's ease of doing business environment is getting more conducive for foreign companies. Now, which state has performed really well in terms of improving its ease of doing business? So it is Maharashtra. Okay, now which state is at the second position? It is Karnataka. Guys, we have discussed these facts. I hope that you remember them. According to the World Bank's Migration and Development Brief 2020, remittances in India would fall by dash percent this year due to the pandemic and recession. Again discussed. So do you recall what are the things that we discussed in this question? So the right answer here is 9%. So this is the actual amount that India is going to receive, and India is the largest country. India is going to receive the largest amount of remittances in 2020 also, as India did in 2019 as well. So that is the major fact about this report. I hope that you remember the other facts as well. Now your task is to tell me that how much, by what percentage FDI will fall, global FDI will fall in 2021. This is your task. This percentage is very important. I have told you this thing in morning tales as well. Which country will host Prosecutor General of SCO in 2020? So basically, there was a meeting of Prosecutors General of SCO. So in 2020 as well. So this was the 18th version, and this year it was held by Uzbekistan. And in 2021, it is going to be organized by India. Okay, so that's all for this question. Remember this thing that you have to remember the facts about SCO. SCO, when was SCO established? Members, then we have the headquarters, and then we have the president. So these are the four static facts which are related to, important from the SCO part, from Shanghai Cooperation Group. So these are four facts. I hope that you will tell me the answers in the comment section, that where is this located, when was it established, how many countries are members, and who is the president at present of this organization. Okay, this was discussed in PIB247 as well. Recently it was discussed by Manish sir in detail, SCO. So I hope that you remember it. Here comes our next section, banking and economy, and that international news section ends. How many banks have been excluded from the second schedule of RBI 1934? Again, we had discussed this. Second schedule elaborates about the commercial banks in India. So how many banks have been excluded? 6. Why are they excluded? Because they have been amalgamated with the major, with other big banks. So these are the 6 PSUs, not PSUs, PSB, public sector banks, that have been excluded from the second schedules because they have been merged with the other public sector banks. Last year merger announced hua tha, I hope that you remember. Recently NABARD has announced a special refinance facility to support the government of India's water sanitization and hygiene program in FY21. How much is the total corpus of the facility? 800 crore. We had discussed about this as well in morning tales. Who is the head of the 3-member interim committee of directors, which was appointed by RBI to run the operations of Dhanlakshmi Bank? So in the month of October, in the very beginning, the shareholders of Dhanlakshmi Bank refused to have Sunil Gurbakhshani as its MD and CEO. Therefore, RBI intervened and formed a committee of directors to run the operations till the appointment of a new CEO. So who heads this committee? This is a 3-member committee. So it will be beneficial for you to remember the names of all the three members in this committee. Now, who is the head? It is G. Subramanya Iyer. Now, guys, where is this Dhanlakshmi Bank located? What is, where is the headquarters and what is the tagline? Tell me in the comment section below. This is your task. Which bank has launched the Gram Sampark Abhiyan, a nationwide financial inclusion and literacy campaign? So, since it has been launched by a bank and the purpose is to spread awareness about financial inclusion or to achieve financial inclusion in India, that's why this is important. So, which bank has launched it? It is Punjab National Bank. I hope that you remember it. We had discussed it in MT. MT's Morning Tales. It's the short form of Morning Tales. How many categories does riskometer of mutual funds have? Now, recently, in the month of October, SEBI has added a new category to this riskometer of mutual funds, and the name itself is suggesting the purpose of this riskometer to tell the risk of a mutual fund scheme. So, the new category was very high until very recently. Until October, there were only 5 categories, still high. And now, very high category has also been added to this riskometer of mutual funds. And now, there are total number of 6 categories. So, that's all for phase 1. You need to remember only these much facts for the phase 1 examination. But in order to understand the entire mechanism and to have an in-depth knowledge of this step, you can watch RBI 24 session, because it will help you in phase 2 and interview. Okay. Which company has launched the Make Small Strong nationwide campaign to support small businesses? So it is Google. Under this Make Small Strong campaign, Google will promote the local businesses and their business. Local businesses and their products. So, local manufacturing will be promoted by Google under this Make Small Strong nationwide campaign. Which bank has become the first bank in India to issue debit card for accounts under the loan and against securities category? So, it is HDFC Bank. Which bank has launched MSME Prerna, an online business mentoring program for MSMEs? Quite an important question. Indian Bank ne launch kiya tha. Theek hai? Ye question bhi hum discuss kar chuke hai. We have discussed it in Morning Tales. What is the GDP growth rate projected by RBI in its Monetary Policy Committee for 2021? So, MPC is important. MPC, MT mein bhi discuss kiya tha, RBI 247 mein bhi discuss kiya hua hai. So, you can watch it in Morning Tales as well and in RBI 247. So, this question is important, guys, because usually RBI does not give their projections so easily, I would say. So, until very end of the year, RBI does not give its projections for the year. So, right now in October itself, in its MPC, RBI gave its projections and it is -9.5%. Remember this number until RBI changes it, and the chances of it are very less. So I hope that this is going to be the ultimate projection from RBI. By how much percentage has the volume of digital payments increased in India between FY16 to FY20? So this question is also very important, and we had discussed it in Morning Tales. So I am not going to discuss the details here again. By volume, 55.1%, and by value, the transactions increased by 15.2%. So this is showing the rapid increase in adoption of online payments. Okay, so here you need to keep that thing in your mind, that why are these numbers important, because they are telling us about the pace of online payments. Which country has received a line of credit of 310 million for the purpose of financing repowering of this thermal power station? Remember, I told you to memorize this thermal power station as well. Can be asked in the examination. So which country is it? So I'm leaving this question on you guys. You have to tell me the right answer, that which country has received this LOC for this thermal power station. I hope that you are good students and you will tell me your answers in the comment section below. What is India's GDP growth rate for FY21 according to IMF's World Economic Outlook report, recent report? So for FY21 it is -10.3. For FY22 it is +8.8%. So okay, for GDP projections, remember the latest one. Okay, I always say this thing, remember the latest one, don't remember the previous projections given by the same organization. Which South Asian country is expected to surpass India in 2020 in terms of nominal GDP according to IMF projections? So on this, if you are following our channel, you would have seen that session taken by Mansi ma'am, especially on the South Asian countries which are performing really well and which are going to surpass India in different sectors. So here this question is also very important, because IMF has given its projections that Bangladesh is going to surpass India in terms of nominal GDP projection in 2020 and also in 2025. So these are some of the facts you need to mug up. How many unicorn startups does India expect to have by 2025 according to COVID-19 and the anti-fragility of India startup ecosystem? Kis organization ne report nikali hai? That is your question for the day. You have to tell me, because I have told you that in Morning Tales. So now I would like to know it from you guys, which organization has released this report? According to this report, by 2025, India is going to have 100 unicorn startups and 62,000 startups in totality. So these are some of the numbers that have been given in this report. What is the minimum sum assured in the Saral Jeevan Bima of IRDAI? So we had also discussed it. It is 5 lakhs. Maximum is 25 lakh, which can be extended at the will of insurance company. So let's move on to the next question. Which bank has sponsored Ashok Nagar Cooperative Bank for issuing ATM, POS and e-commerce services to its customers? So the right answer is Jan Small Bank. Why is it important? Why are we discussing about sponsoring of one bank by another bank? The reason behind this is that Jana Small Finance Bank has become the first small finance bank to finance a cooperative bank. That is why it is important. So remember this thing. Now tell me the CEO of these two banks. Okay. Which bank has recently signed an MOU with Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs and SIDBI for payment of subsidy to street vendors under PM Swanidhi Yojana? I have told you this thing previously as well. Swanidhi is in news for quite a long period of time since its launch. So do watch the session by Manish sir in which this Swanidhi scheme was discussed in detail. So with which bank? It is with Indian Bank. Which company has launched MuPay, a payment gateway for dairy farmers in Rajasthan? Remember, MuPay, the name, the payment gateway for dairy farmers and Rajasthan. So these, the words circled by me are the keywords. You have to remember the keywords. So which company has launched it? It is Stellapps. So it is a startup. So it has launched this MuPay app. Who heads the SEBI's Market Data Advisory Committee formed to ensure that market data is made freely accessible to all? We had discussed it in the Morning Tales as well. So guys, can you recall that which person is this? Who is the head of this committee? It is Madhavi Puri Puch. So it is, she is the right answer. Which state government has partnered with BSE and Global Linker to help its MSMEs raise equity funds. Discussed. It was also discussed. So it is in Telangana. Telangana has partnered with BSE and Global Linker. Bond Blocks Bond Exchange. Where is this Bond Blocks Bond Exchange? The world's first blockchain-based bond exchange located. So where is it located? It is in Singapore. Such kind of static questions are really important. They can be asked in the examination. Who heads the IRDAI's panel on standard cyber liability insurance product? So we had discussed it in morning test. So I hope that majority of you should know the answer who are following the morning test regularly. And I am again repeating myself, watch the sessions regularly, because this session will only help you revising the current affairs when you watch the regular sessions. Because when I'm saying this, who heads this panel, then you will easily recall the details that I have told you in the previous session of morning test. So now you have to tell me that who is the head. So it is P. Umesh. Okay. As per RBI's new norms for housing finance firms, HFFs must have -% of all their assets in housing finance and -% in individual loans by 2024 respectively. So in the month of October itself, RBI gave its guidelines for housing finance companies. In those guidelines, RBI has given the limits for the HFFs to maintain their assets in housing finance as well as in individual loans. So there was a certain percentage that they need to achieve by the year 2024. So what is the percentage? It is 60% and 50%. Now guys, they are not required to achieve this immediately. This is by 2024. And in order to achieve this limit, the limits were given for the phase-wise limits were given that you have to achieve a certain percentage by the year 2022, then by 2023 a certain percentage, and by 2024 your assets should be this much. So that's all for this question. This was also discussed by Mansi ma'am in detail. So I hope that you have seen the RBI 24 session. Okay, so here our next question is, how many state duties will be covered to calculate the consumer price index for industrial workers with a new base year 2016? So the CPI-IW has been recently changed. Its base year was earlier 2001 and now it has been changed to 2006. Now those who are following the sessions provided by us would know that it has been covered in PIB 247 in detail. From the phase one perspective, I have provided you the question and the right answer is 28 states. Earlier, the CPI-IW, which was prepared earlier with the base year of 2001, in that 25 states were assessed and now the number has been increased to 28 states and duties. Apart from this, there were other changes as well, but those changes are important from phase 2 perspective and are covered in detail by Manish sir in PIB 247. So watch that session guys, it will help you. What is the average projected gross fiscal deficit of states for FY21 as per the state finances a budget study of budgets of 2020 to 2021 report by RBI? Now this report is important because it has been released by RBI and not many facts were provided under this report. From the phase one point of view, there was only one fact that was of great importance, and that was that the GFD, that is gross fiscal deficit of states, is going to increase to 4.6% in FY21 due to this pandemic. So that's the most important fact from this news. Which bank has signed a loan agreement of $1 billion with Japan Bank of International Cooperation for financing the Japanese automobiles in India? We had discussed it in morning test. So now guys, can you tell me the answer? I am waiting for your answers in the comment section below. And Now, I'm leaving this question for you to answer because I have discussed it and it is not a very difficult question. Which of the following agency is funding the phase 2 and phase 3 of externally aided dam rehabilitation and improvement project of India? Now, this project has been recently approved by Union Cabinet, and under this rehabilitation project, dams will be strengthened and their embankments will be built in order to build the resiliency of dams so that they don't get flooded away in the case of tsunamis or floods. So for this project, for the phase 2 and phase 3 of this project, India has collaborated with Asian Infrastructure and Investment Bank, AIIB, and World Bank. So the right option is option E. Okay guys, so banking section khatam hua. Ab hamara appointment section hai. The questions that I had discussed from the banking and economy section are the most important from the month of October. There were other questions as well, but I thought they were not very difficult, that they require any kind of explanation. So they were very easy questions, so I left them out, but you can find those questions in the monthly magazine Spotlight. Link provided hai description. Okay, so this is appointments. Who has been appointed as a chairman of SBI? Dinesh Khara. MD and CEO of India Post Payment Banks, it is J. Venkatramu. Okay, so this is a South Indian name, so you have to remember this thing. Director General of Bureau of Civil Aviation Security, it is M.A. Ganpati. Remember, we had discussed it, and why is it important? Because of that Aircrafts Amendment Bill 2020, and I had covered that bill as well. So watch the morning tail session in which I had discussed Aircraft Amendment Bill. Chairman of Association of Mutual Funds in India, it is Nilesh Shah. So these are very crisp current affairs where you need to remember only three words: the name, the position, and the organization. Okay. CEO of Hindustan Zinc, Arun Mishra. Vice Chair of OECD Working Group on Good Laboratory Practice. So this was an Indian. So the Indian is Ekta Kapoor. So she is very, she is also with, no, not the same person. Ekta Kapoor is also the Queen of Television. So in case if you find any kind of difficulty in remembering this name, then you can remember it through that as well. So who watch TV a lot can easily remember this thing, that Ekta Kapoor. Remember this thing, that the persons are different. Ekta Kapoor is a scientist. So she has been appointed as the vice chair of this group. Who has been elected as the chairman of Indian Banks Association for 2020 to 2021? Raj Kiran Rai ji, we had discussed it, and he is the present CEO and MD of which bank? Tell me in the comment section. I had told you that in the morning tales. Elected as the chairperson of governing body of ILO. So remember that it is after of a long period of 35 years that India has been appointed as the chair of this governing body of ILO. So who is that person? It is Apurv Chandra. CMD of Cognizant Technology. This is a very prominent company. So who is the CMD? It's Rajesh Nambiar. CEO of Electronic Sector Skill Council of India. This was very recent question. In the last couple of videos, I have discussed this question. So I hope that you remember. So the right answer is PVG Menon. Okay. So major appointments for the month of October are over. Now let's discuss important days. Which decade is celebrated as decade of healthy aging? Again, discussed in morning tales. So tell me which decade it is. For now, I'll tell you that this decade was announced as part of the celebration of International Day for Older Person, which is celebrated on October 1st. So this decade is celebrated during 2020 to 2030. And now your task is to find out the theme of this day, International Day of Older Persons for 2020. Theme find out करो और बताओ मुझे. वर्ल्ड हैबिटेट डे की थीम क्या थी 2020 में? हाउसिंग फॉर ऑल, अ बेटर अर्बन फ्यूचर. नाउ अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस, देयर इज वन मोर फैक्ट फ्रॉम दिस न्यूज, दैट इंडोनेशियन सिटी इज गोइंग टू हैव द ग्लोबल ऑब्जर्वेंस ऑफ दिस वर्ल्ड हैबिटेट डे. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दैट? That the global celebration of this day will be hosted by Indonesia's city Surabaya. So this question is important, can be asked in the examination. In fact, I would say that such a question was asked in the examination, I guess, last year. जिसमें सिटी पूछा था, कौन सी किसी स्पेशल डे की सिटी पूछी थी. तो पर्पस इज हियर, द मेन मोटो इज टू टेल यू दैट दिस काइंड ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन इज ऑल्सो रेलिवेंट. सो रिमेंबर दिस थिंग. ओके, थीम हो गया, ये हो गया, डेट रह गई. व्हाट इज द डेट ऑफ वर्ल्ड हैबिटेट डे? टेल मी इन द कमेंट सेक्शन बिलो. आई हैव डिस्कस्ड इट. वर्ल्ड स्पेस वीक 2021, व्हाट इज द थीम फॉर द वर्ल्ड स्पेस वीक 2021? डू पे अटेंशन टू 2021. आई एम नॉट आस्किंग यू अबाउट 2020. सो हियर दिस क्वेश्चन हाईलाइट्स द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ रीडिंग द क्वेश्चंस केयरफुली. सो इन द एग्जाम एज वेल, कीप काम, कीप योर माइंड काम एंड रीड द क्वेश्चन केयरफुली. ओके, नाउ 2021 की थीम इज वुमेन इन साइंस, 2022 की थीम सैटेलाइट, 2020 सॉरी, इट इज द थीम ऑफ 2020, सैटेलाइट्स इंप्रूव लाइफ, इट इज दिस ईयर थीम. And Women in Space is 2021 theme. And when is this week observed? October 4 to 10. So these are the dates. International Day of Girl Child. What is the theme of the International Day of Girl Child? It is My Voice, Our Equal Future. When is this day observed? Guys, do you know this thing? I have discussed it in Morning Tales. So I would like to hear it from you. When is this day observed? Which is the first African country to host the World Cities Day global observance? Again, a question from that segment only, where I am going to ask you about the city which is going to host the global observance. So the right answer is Kenya, and the importance of Kenya is that it is the first African country. Okay, when is this World Cities Day observed? It is observed on October 31st. What is the theme? Tell me in the comment section. Vigilance Awareness Week. Theme is Vigilant India, Prosperous India. Again, remember that we had discussed about a national conference organized by CBI on corruption and on corruption. So the theme of that national conference was also the same, Vigilant India and Prosperous India. Important days is over. Award section पे चलते हैं. Award section है. Recently, Robert Lewandowski has been awarded the UEFA Men's Player of the Year 2019-20. Which country does he belong to? It is Poland. Now, what is the full form of UEFA? Union of European Football Associations. Who has been conferred the Lifetime Achievement Award and Global Excellence Awards by the Indo-American Chamber of Commerce? So it is Ratan Tata. It's important, okay? Remember this thing. Which bank CMO is the only CMO of an Indian company in the Forbes list of the world's most influential CMOs? So we have been given five options. Out of these five options, it is option C, that is HDFC Bank. HDFC Bank CEO, that is Ravi Senkatraman, is the right answer of this question. Guys, I think I'm a little confused in the name of CMO of HDFC Bank. So you need to know this thing. Who is the CMO of HDFC Bank? Tell me in the comment section below. अदरवाइज आई विल टेल यू आफ्टर दिस सेशन इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. ओके, हु अमंग द फॉलोइंग हैज वन द नोबेल प्राइज इन लिटरेचर फॉर 2020. सो अक्टूबर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज नोबेल प्राइजेज वर अनाउंस्ड. सो देर वर सिक्स कैटेगरीज इन विच नोबेल प्राइजेज आर अनाउंस्ड एंड इन लिटरेचर इट वॉज लुईस ग्लुक. Now your task is to, you have to remember the other category winners. Remember this thing, we had discussed this question in Morning Tales as well as the award winners or as well as the Nobel winners in other categories. I hope that you remember who won the 2020 Shastra Ramanujan Prize. It is Shai Evra. Again discuss, so details, I hope that you are able to recall the details that I have told you when I discussed this question. Which of the following personalities have partnered to launch Earthshot Prize? It's Prince William and David Attenborough. So the right answer is both A and B. Now guys, do you remember that Earthshot Prize is the world's prestigious prize because of the amount of its prize, it's the worth of its prize money. So now it's your task that you will tell me that how much is the worth of this Earthshot prize. I had told you this thing in the Morning Tales session. Who has become the first Indian wildlife photographer to win this highly commended award at the Wildlife Photography of the Year 2020? So it is Aishwarya Sridhar. And the photo that has got this award, that has harnessed this award for her, has also a name. So what is the name of that photo? I have mentioned it in the comment section below. It's a very curious question, that's why I'm asking you. So you have to tell me that what's the name of that photo. Which of the following bank has won the Central Bank of the Year Award 2020? So it is Bank of Ghana. Now this is a very important question because it's about the central bank. Recently, an India-Bhutan joint hydropower project has received the Brunel Medal for excellence in civil engineering. What is the name of the project? Guys, do you remember? We had discussed about this question and all these options are the names of different hydroelectric power projects that India and Bhutan are jointly constructing in Bhutan. So out of these five options, what is the right answer? It is Mang Dechu. Mang Dechu hydroelectric project is has won this Brunel Medal for excellence in civil engineering. Which company is India's top ranked PSU in the Forbes World's Best Employers list 2020 NTPC? We had discussed it. Which is India's safest bank according to World Safest Banks Ranking 2020? It is SBI. Covered in Morning Tales, so I'm not telling you the details here. I hope that you are able to recall the details that India's safest bank is SBI, World's safest bank is KfW in Germany, and Asia's safest bank is DBS, Singapore. So the award section is complete and now we are heading towards the sports section. Who has been appointed as the brand ambassador of Transform, India's first indigenous badminton racket brand? We had discussed it in Morning Tales. So what is the right answer? It is Chetan Anand. He's the tennis player and he has been appointed as the brand ambassador of Transform. Remember the name of this brand because it is India's first indigenous badminton racket brand. Who has won French Open 2020 in the women's single category? It is Iga Swiatek. And men's single category, it is Rafael Nadal. Which football club has won I-League 2019-2020? So I-League is India's football league. So which football club has won it? Mohan Bagan. So it is the Calcutta club. It is located in Calcutta. So it has won this league. Denisa Denmark Open, which is a badminton tournament. So in men's category, who has won this Denisa Denmark Open 2020? It is Anders Antonsen, who has won Egypt Open in men's category. It is Ali Farag, an Egyptian, who has won it in the female category. That you will be telling me in the comment section. I had discussed it in Morning Tales. So right now I am going to hear it from you guys. Tell me, come on, that who has won it in women's section? Which country has won the gold in women's category in Asia Nations Regions Online Chess Championship 2020? It is India. विमेन्स में इंडिया ने गोल्ड जीता है, मेंस में इंडिया ने सिल्वर जीता है. सो रिमेंबर दिस थिंग. नाउ मेंस में किस कंट्री ने गोल्ड जीता है, टेल मी इन द कमेंट सेक्शन बिलो. सो हियर द स्पोर्ट्स सेक्शन एंड्स एंड नाउ मिसलेनियस सेक्शन बिगिन. सो इन मिसलेनियस सेक्शन वी हैव ऑब्जेक्टिव्स, वी हैव बुक्स एंड अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ न्यूज फ्रॉम हियर एंड देयर. सो हियर the first question is, whose memoir is titled as unfinished? Memoirs, biographies are important. So it is Priyanka Chopra, who is now the Priyanka Chopra Jones, who is the author of the Khalistan Conspiracy, a former raw officer unravels the path to 1984 book. It is GBS Sidhu. If you guys are following MT regularly, so you would know the answer. Author of Battle of Belonging, Shashi Tharoor. Quite an interesting writer is he is. So if you are interested, you can read this book as well. Portraits of Power is the biography of N.K. Singh, chairman of 15th Finance Commission. Who is the author of The Fixer? Winning has a prize. How much will you pay? Book. So this book, remember we had discussed about this thing. So right now I am going to tell you the author. Now on whose life is this book is written or is based? That is your question. You have to tell me. I have told you in Morning Tales. So now it's your task that you will tell me that on whose life is this book based on. Okay. Suman Dubey is the answer. He is the author of this book. Who is the author of Night of the Restless Spirit Stories from 1984? So it is Sarbpreet Singh. So a lot of books from 1984 riots are being coming up, are being written nowadays. Who has authored Bye Bye Corona, world's first signed-tone book, recently discussed in the Morning Tale? So I hope that you remember the answer. It is Pradeep Kumar Shrivastav. So here our session ends for the day. I hope that you are able to remember all the current affairs that I have told you for the month of October. And in case you have not seen the video in which I have covered the national news of October month, then you can find it in the list description box. The link is provided there. I hope that you have really enjoyed this section, this session, and do tell us about your feedback in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching the video.